G'day. I've not used diamond inserts before, which will probably become obvious, but I thought I would buy a couple and give it a go on some clear acrylic. Now my lathe, this is the usual arrangement. With this arrangement it will only reach 3000 RPM, but when I fit that pulley and belt it will go to 4000 RPM, which will give us half of the surface speed we need. That's the best I can do. I tried to buy some larger acrylic, but it was just too expensive. So there's my software showing 4000 RPM. Any more than that and tells you to go away. So now, these parts I'm turning, the turned part, the length is split into three different feeds because basically I don't know what I'm doing. So I did it that way to try and find out what would be a good idea to do. Right, and as you can see there, the three different feeds along the length, you can just see a difference in the surface finish. I think that's the diamond insert by Pinnacle Tools, which I purchased from eBay. We'll just have a look at this roughing now. I won't subject you to that with the other parts that we do. We'll just do the finish pass for the dome. This is just the clean-up cut after the roughing. And then there's the finish pass. If you look, you can actually see along that turned surface, there is a difference in the surface finish. It's just not very noticeable with this insert. Okay. Next, we have a Sumitomo diamond insert. Again, using the three different feeds along the length, and I think you can see it's quite obvious there that there is a difference in the surface finish as the speed is varied. Here we've gone straight forward to the finishing pass for the dome. It's funny, I could have sworn I sped that up somewhere along there. Right, now this is a Sumitomo AG insert for aluminium. And again, you can see a difference in the surface finish. I think that was doing 2400 RPM for a surface speed of 300 meters per minute. And there's the finishing pass of the dome again. Now, this turning is all done at 0.01 feed per rev. It's that funny shape because I did start a bit of a video where I had the wrong insert in, so I had to stop it halfway, and hence the funny shape. Okay, here's the finishing pass of the dome. You see there's quite a bit more reflection there on that turned part. Oh, thank goodness someone sped that up. Now, I was quite surprised at the clarity of this. When you're just looking at it, you don't get to see much because it's not close enough to the back surface for you to ever see anything. But I was quite surprised. Now, at the end of this video, I've got the four parts I've done set up against a lined grid, so that you can actually see through them and see the lines close up behind, and it's quite telling as to how clear the different parts are. This is just a spring pass I did on one of the parts to see if it made any difference, and you can see it has got a lot shinier. It's probably just a burnishing effect rather than cutting. Why so much is coming off this is what is supposed to be a spring pass on the dome, I don't know. Haven't a clue. Now, anyone who watches my videos will know that I love to have a whinge about the mess that it always makes. You should have seen it all stuck to my camera. It was amazing. These are the inserts, Sumitomo on the left, which has some damage from a later video that I did after this one. The AG in the centre and the Pinnacle Tool a diamond insert on the right. That's what I did to the Sumitomo insert. Now, here's these parts set up behind the grid. The three on the right was set up, were actually cut in the same program, and the one on the left has the spring pass in it. You can see the AG didn't do that badly compared with the others, according to what you can see there. Alright, thank you for watching.